Good evening. I'm here on behalf of Gale of Waterdeep. He wishes to extend you an invitation for a private conversation in a more suitable locale. Gladly. Simply follow yonder path, and soon you will find him. Good evening. I'm here on behalf of Gale of Water. Gladly. Simply follow.
I love this time of night. There's an almost reverent silence that accompanies the peak of darkness, when you'd almost believe the dawn will never break. The cradle of eternity. The timelessness of lovers. That most beautiful of fantasies. I will be. Soon. I am perhaps just one hard day away from being without any troubles at all. This may be my last night alive. I wanted it to be under a canopy of beauty and wonder. I thought this place might bring me peace. I thought it might make the weight of what I must do feel a little lighter. But I'm not so sure. Babe or crone, coward or hero, death is assured. Mistra's forgiveness is not. If you knew the end was near, would you not want to ensure it had meaning? I am terrified. I will not claim otherwise. My face could scarcely conceal it, even if my words sought to deny it. There is no point in running from the inevitable. Better to meet it on my own terms. Yes, but there is so much to live for and so few moments in which to house it all. Damn you for giving me so much to care about. Our friends, our adventures. This would have been so much easier if it was just me, but it isn't. If there is a way, any way, to save all that's grown dear to me, I want to seize it. I just cannot fathom what that might be, other than to fail Mistra and condemn the world. Stay with me, will you? I don't want to think of it anymore, but I don't want to be alone either.
Stone or steel.
I was hoping to speak to you, as a matter of fact, about the night you were kind enough to keep this melancholy wizard company. I wanted to thank you. I was sinking into a dark place, but you reminded me there is still light in the world, if I should care to look for it. You may well have prevented me from doing something very rash in the near future. I count myself lucky to call you a friend. Careful. I may just take you up on that.
I question the wisdom of that decision, but so be it.
I'll be in the camp then, idling away the hours.
These lands may not be under the thrall of Lady Shar for much longer. No matter. She wishes for Kethric Thorn to be punished. Her darkness was a blessing offered before he betrayed her. She can redirect her powers elsewhere once he is cast down. All right. Some company wouldn't hurt on the road, especially if there's trouble. I am ready.
Let's get going.
Don't touch me.
Attention!
Can't give up now.
I can feel the shadow's power here, but they don't seem to be harming me. The shadow curse. It doesn't seem to affect me like it does others. Not as badly, at least. Do you know what this means? I must be blessed. Lady Shah is protecting me where others are left to face her wrath. She loves me. She must do. Lady Shah wouldn't bless me like this for no reason. There must be something she wants of me. Those signs we found about Dark Justicias, perhaps they were no coincidence. In either case, I need to watch for any place dedicated to Lady Shah. A temple, perhaps.
Our hero thought but a treasure ahead, did not consider the peace of the dead. Through the dark he went creeping and awoke what was sleeping. A new grave they dug, which he himself fed.
Ooh, spooky!
Until it was perfect. I've grown quite fond of you, you know, in my way. I thought it only fair to warn you about the dangers ahead. Oh, we both know they are soon to be revealed. It would be pointless of me to try to bar you from entering. But I can set the scene, as it were, prepare you for your role. There is a stage down in the dark, upon which a great drama has suspended itself in time. Its actors dwell there still, mired in the languor of their long-tired scenes. If you, however, through the dark, go creeping and awake what is sleeping, chances are many more graves than yours alone will soon be fed. Very well. There is a creature that lurks in silence and shadow. A creature who, like me, is very much of the infernal persuasion. Should it make its way out through the very doors you are about to brazenly swing open, you'll have unleashed a pestilence upon this realm. In truth, it is carnage incarnate. So if you meet the devil of which I speak, kill it. Consider no other course of action. This creature and I go back a long way. I admit, it would be in my best interest as well, should it remain trapped in the dark. Or misplace its head, perhaps?
What are we talking here? Lemia? Pit Fiend? Orthon?
getting warmer. Warmer. Hot. Listen here, Pipsqueak. Do not underestimate this opponent. At best, you will have the blink of an eye to strike. Strike first, strike true, defy the odds, for they are distinctly in its favor. That much I owe the bastard to concede.
Wait. Before you go, I have a proposal of my own.
A proposal? If you're hoping to taste my blood, little vampling, think again. It burns hotter than wyvern whiskey.
This is serious business, devil. My old... Well, a long time ago, someone carved some runes into my back. I'd rather like to know what they say.
It's something of great importance to your master. But is it a love letter, a warning, or a deed of ownership? I can give you all the gory details, and I will. Once the beast that lurks below is vanquished and sent back to the Hells. You haven't told them, and you've kept your clothes on this whole time. How unlike you. Why not let them see? Don't be shy.
God damn it.
Don't pout, Spawn. Just destroy the beast, and I'll happily reveal your secrets instead of your skin.
Yes, fine. We'll kill this damn creature of yours.
Then we have an understanding. I look forward to our next meeting. Scars often tell such wonderful stories. I think yours might be truly exquisite.
Well, now you know. I... Perhaps I should have. But I'm not used to asking for help and being met with, well... help. But what's done is done. So how about we stop discussing it and just kill this beast? Although I should probably get dressed first.
Sigils. Attempts to restrain Lady Shah's power, perhaps. Failed attempts.
Melodia Thorm, beloved wife and mother. E Armiel Tellere Manon here.
Bones everywhere. Someone's been engaging in dark rituals here.
Place for the Lord of the Dead.
An open
There's
tomb.
More to this place.
Empty.
I'm sure of it.
Not ominous in
Lady Shah's presence is near.
Sussun Elg Olaf.
Isabella set off with it before Ketherick brought her back.
Ketherick Thorm leading Shah's forces. Quite the about face for a warrior of Saluna.
Oh dear.
Someone's left a trap out for us.
Best avoid that trap.
Ketherick Thorm, bowed by grief for his daughter. Ketherick Thorm leading Shah's forces. Quite the about face for a warrior of Saluna. It's moonrise, or it used to be.
Be careful. There are traps about.
Disc must be the way forward.
Where will it bring us, though?
Dedicated to the goddess Shah, which probably isn't good news.
Shah, singer of eternal night, protector of the lost and forgotten.
Who speaks?
Step carefully. There's a trap.
Current structure, going by the design.
Shah's warriors must not be caught, must not be tricked. Only loss awaits the unworthy.
A voice.
Be wary. This place is trapped.
What the hell was that?
Step carefully. There's a trap. Step carefully. There's a trap.
hells was that?
Watch out, there's a trap.
What the hell's with that?
Voice and prove your worth.
It down here. It's nice. Homey.
This is a dedication to my goddess's power and dark beauty.
You do not belong here.
Your mind upends. Somehow, in the decayed soup of this creature's brain, a tadpole lives. Another presence nurtures it, manipulates it like a puppet.
No, you do not belong. This is the Dark Lady's house. She is no use for old, faithless bones.
You plunder! You meddle! You upset my plans. Leave. I'm their creator. I saved them from life. From death. From their skin and their flesh. Now they serve me. Leave before... Stupid worm-infested cockhead! You have awoken the shadows! My forces are split. The defenses are thin. Rally on me. A wall of bone and blade against the darkness. Now!
Way. this is my happy place. Go time. Over there.
Lady Shah, so many must have toiled to make a visage so grand. It's beautiful.
Rancid donkey scrotum! The quakes herald the shadows! It's already too late.
trespasser. Burkle's fat dog.
Thank you.
in position.
The dance macabre. My breath. Traps, please.
Blood comes easy these days. Time to press ahead.
Close ranks.
I'm ready.
One piece as well. Not just any true soul would have succeeded in following my path through this place. You should be pleased. General Thorn. Rubbish. Everything is at hand here. Zarel merely envies the General's faith in me. I am in the midst of a grand strategy. But you're here now, and I may be able to put those limbs to work. You know what's at stake here, I take it. General Thorn to you. But yes, recovering the relic is the crux of it. He commands, and I, his humble servant, fulfill that command. While you, an infinitely more humble servant, fulfill my command. I will put you to work as a scout. Lends the General his strength, his invulnerability. It must be recovered before his enemies attempt to exploit it. I do not need you or your help, but you are here in spite of that, so I may as well make use of you. The relic is close, but the way is barred and Shah's dead are uncooperative. Clear the path for me by blade, cunning, or whatever it takes. I will remain here until you have succeeded or fallen.
I'd trust this gas bag about as far as I can throw him, which isn't far. But perhaps better to play along for now.
I will assign flesh to aid you on your way. Ring this bell, and he will come. My brother is no intellectual powerhouse, but he is strong, loyal, and punctual. Should a fight turn against you, remember the bell. In part, yes. My poor unborn twin. Mother always resented me for it, said I strangled him in the womb. If you can believe such tripe. Besides, Once I developed my powers, I fetched him from the graveyard and brought him back. Gave him a new, better body. Alas, Mother was not pleased. We're still close. She's in a jar on the shelf over there. Flesh will remain here until called. But don't fear, he has very sharp hearing. I chose his ears myself. Now, get to work.